Hello and welcome to Fairfield University Student Radio 88.5 FM. I'm Ryan Canfield, alongside me Andrew Jameson. We are here in Atlantic City at Jim Whelan Boardwalk Hall for the MAAC Men's Semifinal Tournament, where the two-seeded Fairfield Stags will host the three-seeded Marist Red Foxes. We just watched an incredible game unfold where St. Peter's hit a buzzer-beater put-back layup to upset the number one-seeded Quinnipiac. And Andrew, the winner of Fairfield Marist will have a date for the championship game tomorrow night.
Yes, that was an incredible game we just saw as St. Peter's won on a buzzer beater. However, we expect a great matchup here tonight between the Fairfield Stags and Marist Red Foxes, who have had two matchups and have split the season series at one apiece. Looking at those matchups, January 7th, Caleb Fields had a career-high 33 points and 10 made three-pointers. That propelled the Stags to an 82-61 victory. However, back on March 1st, just 2 weeks ago, they lost 58-55, knocked out of first place in the MAAC. They were led by 7 at half, but were outscored by 10, and one of their worst shooting nights, shooting just 28% from the court.
In that first matchup where Fairfield won 82-61, second team All-MAAC player Max Allen II did not play in that game. And for the Stags, Caleb Fields had not only a career high in makes and attempts from three, he went 10 from 18 from deep that game, having a career high 33 points in that win. On the other hand, in Fairfield's loss in Poughkeepsie, New York, where Marist won that game 58-55, that was one of Fairfield's worst shooting performances of the season. The Stags shot 28.3% from the field that game, 28.6% from three, and only 61.9% from the free throw line, far below where they normally average in the season. Caleb Fields had 15 in that loss, while Jalen Leach and Bryson Goodine were the only other Stags in double figures that game. Andrew, let's reset for a moment. How did Marist get here?
Well, let's not forget, Marist was down 12 at halftime versus the Niagara Purple Eagles. However, they came storming back, outscoring Niagara by 18. Huge part of that was Jaden Collins, who led the Red Foxes with 20 points on 82% shooting. His confidence and game only grew stronger as the game went on, and Marist was clutch from the free throw line in the whole game, 15 of 19. Javon Cooley absolutely contributed as well, 14 points in his own right, and Jackson Price had 12 off the bench.
And it was paramount that Jaden Collins were to step up for the Red Foxes because their stud, as we mentioned, Max Allen earlier, second team All-MAAC, he was in foul trouble. Jaden Collins had a career-high 20 points in the comeback victory on 9 of 11 shooting, and at one point scored 10 consecutive points in the second half, in addition to having a career-high 5 steals in their comeback victory last night against Niagara. In that game, Marist shot 52.3% from the field and shot an astounding 59.1% as a team in the second half. Now, something to be curious and something to note here tonight, Andrew, that was Marist's fifth straight victory when trailing by 8 or more at the half. And as last night's win was also their fifth win this season when trailing in a game by double digits. This is a team you cannot discount.
Marist is a team that bends but does not break, Ryan. They are 3-1 in one possession games this season. That was on full display against Niagara last night.
And Andrew, a lot of the horses for Marist are younger guys. We mentioned Max Allen, he's a sophomore. We mentioned Jaden Collins, he's a freshman. We haven't even mentioned freshman Josh Pascarelli, who was a unanimous selection for the all-rookie team.
And this is a young upstart Marist Red Foxes team who is looking to make some noise. Made it as far as the championship game in the MAAC tournament last season, losing to Iona. Nonetheless, this confidence of the Red Foxes is high right now.
So let's turn the page over to the two-seeded Fairfield Stags. They come off a victory against Iona. It was a 68-63 win, gave the Stags 21 wins on the season, which is now tied for the sixth most in program history. And something to note, Andrew, that win snapped a 7-game losing streak for the Stags against the Gales and marked Fairfield's first postseason win over Iona since 2012. How did they get there, and why are they in the semifinals?
And
tonight?
It comes from your two main scorers, two of your veteran guys, Jalen Leach and Caleb Fields, who have gotten it done all season for Fairfield, got it done once again, as Jalen Leach had 22, 8 rebounds, and 4 steals. Caleb Fields had 20 in his own right, and the Stags were calm, cool, and collected from the free throw line, made the most of their opportunities, and sealed the game for the Stags.
Now, something that was very interesting was Alexis Yetna made his first start of the season last night. What are you expecting from Yetna tonight?
Now, I expect Yetna to be as physical as ever. He looks 100% back from that injury, which kept him out at least through mid February, so I expect them to be a force in the paint. Fairfield won the rebounding battle versus Ionas 38-32. They need to win the rebound battle once again tonight to have a lead and build it.
All right, well, don't go anywhere. We're going to come right back after we take a quick break with our keys to the game and starting lineups for tonight. Welcome back here. We are moments away from tip-off, and we are about to get starters. But, Andrew, what do you think the keys to the game are for Marist if they want to move on to face St. Peter's tomorrow night?
We mentioned just a little bit ago, you have to win the Battle of the Boards. More specifically, put an emphasis on Max Allen. Max Allen absolutely held his own against WVOF as he fouled out late in that game, and that proved to be pivotal in Marist's victory as they went on a run after he fouled out. Also, you have to keep the offensive aggression up from start to finish. We mentioned Marist being a team that bend but doesn't break. Fairfield's offense has to be consistent from the first bucket to the last.
And for the Stags, you mentioned 1-on-1 in the season. The game they lost was a real slugfest, grinded-out game. What are you looking for the Stags so they can move on to against St. Peter's tomorrow night?
I think with the Stags, it's a matter of pace. You know, the Stags love this high, prolific offense that shoots a bunch of threes, pushes it up the court with high-flying speed and elusiveness. I expect them to get back to their passing in aggressive ways offensively, try to throw Marist off their feet a little bit because they just came off of a grueling battle against Niagara. Even though it is more than 24 hours, that nonetheless is still taking a fatigue on some of those Red Foxes down there.
Andrew, who are you expecting to be an X factor for the Fairfield Stags tonight?
For the Fairfield Stags, you have to look at Jasper Floyd, who has been a pickpocket all season. Led the MAAC in steals with 75 himself in the running for defensive player of the year, rightfully so. He's going to have to do that once again tonight to disrupt this Marist offense.
And after last night, his steals total is actually up to 77, and Jasper Floyd has the Fairfield program record for most steals in a single season. Now, Andrew, what are you looking for to be the X factor for Marist tonight?
I think Marist, you have to rely on these young guys, Josh Pascarelli and Jaden Collins. They are a huge reason why you're here tonight, and if you're Marist, you have to ride the hot hand. This team is built on youth. It has propelled them to where they are right now. You have to continue to feed the hot hand. Still, nonetheless, some of your veteran players have to step up, like Daughtry and Javon Cooley.
All right. Well, Andrew, thank you very much for that. We're going to take a quick break. We will have starters and tip-off just next. Don't go anywhere. Welcome back to Fairfield University Student Radio 88.5 FM. I'm Ryan Canfield. He's Andrew Jameson. We're in Atlantic City, about to have tip-off here. Jim Whelan, boardwalk hole between the Stags and the Red Foxes. For Marist, head coach John Dunn is sending out freshman Jaden Collins, Jaden Daughtry, Max Allen, Josh Pasquarelli, and Javon Cooley as his starting five. Fairfield running with the same starting five in their matchup against Iona. Caleb Fields, Jalen Leach, Jasper Floyd, Alexis Yetna making his second career start with Fairfield, and Louis Bleachmore. Going from our right to the left, the Stags will be going to the left, the Marist will be going to our right. Marist will have the red uniforms on with white piping, white lettering, and white numbers on their uniform. The Stags in their white uniforms with red lettering, red numbering, gray piping down the sides, and a red outline on their uniforms.
As we mentioned earlier in the broadcast, Marist looking to advance to back-to-back MAAC Conference Tournament Finals. Fairfield looking to advance their first MAAC final since 2021.
Fairfield holds the all-time record between these two teams over Marist. Fairfield is 43-28 all-time against Marist. They're 1-1 against each other this season, and tonight will settle the best of three, and tonight's best of three will decide who has a date with St. Peter's tomorrow night right back here for who will win the MAAC championship.
And closely as their ride, their ticket to the dance depends on who wins this game. That they're the final obstacle in St. Peter's path, so they are definitely all eyes here.
Fairfield will send 6'6 Louis Bleachmore out for the tip. Marist will send out 6'9 Max Allen II for the tip. Both teams are ready. The referee's ready. And we're off here in Atlantic City. The tip is tipped back towards Jasper Floyd, and Fairfield will start with the ball first. Alexis Yetna now hands it off to Fields. Fields at the top of the key, passes to Floyd on the far wing. Jasper Floyd back to Louis Bleachmore, top of the key. Swing to Leach. Caleb Fields in the near corner now. Fields drive with his right, step back three is no good. Rims out, rebound corralled down by Jaden Daughtry, who hands it off to Jaden Collins.
Look for Caleb Fields to set the tone offensively here.
Collins now over to Allen. Max Allen, top of the key. The sophomore holds. He's on the far wing, gives it back to Collins now. Collins guarded by Fields. Collins is going to pass it into Allen, working on Bleachmore. Allen is going to kick it back out. Daughtry now. Daughtry spinning. He's going to do a quick little bounce pass to Allen. Allen gets double teamed and goes out of bounds. The backside help from Jalen Leach forced a turnover.
And that's what the Stags are going to have to do all night, Ryan. Max Allen is an absolute force in the paint. The more you double him, the higher the probability he will turn the ball over.
Allen led the Red Foxes in scoring with 11.9 points per game this season, second team All-MAAC selection. Jalen Leach now with the ball. He's going to dribble to his left, step back, pump fake. He's going to get it to Louis Bleachmore on a pass that was tipped. Now Jasper Floyd on the far wing. Floyd dribbles back to the top of the key, gives it to Fields, who passes to Leach. Leach on the near wing, dribbles to his left, three, no good. Rebound corralled by Pasquarelli. Pasquarelli now. Guarded by Floyd. He's going to pass it into Allen. Allen guarded by Yetna. Allen goes up for the layup. It's good.
That's going to be a marquee matchup to watch all night. Two absolute heavyweights in the paint there. Allen gets the upper hand there.
The first points of the game belong to Marist. It's a 2-0 game, just under 18 and a half minutes left here in the first half. Leach driving into the lane, goes up for a floater, and it'll be a jump ball. Good defense from the Red Foxes. The possession arrow will go towards Marist. It'll be Marist ball.
You know, watching Fairfield all season, Jalen Leach absolutely loves driving to the paint in that fadeaway shot. Max Allen met him there for the stop.
Fairfield in a bit of a loose press. Caleb Fields meeting Jaden Collins in his own side of the court. Collins now past midcourt, passes down to Cooley, who gives it back to Collins immediately. Collins now dribbling, gets it to Allen at the top of the key. Allen with a major mismatch on Fields. Drives to the paint, Leach again with the backside help. The ball is loose, and it will be a kicked ball, Fairfield ball. We've now seen twice Jalen Leach with the backside help.
Yeah, Fairfield not taking any chances when it comes to Max Allen. He is the leading scorer on this Red Foxes team. Look for Fairfield to try to force the ball to other playmakers for Marist.
And Allen is by far the biggest player on this court and has multiple times already tried to back down Fairfield defenders into the paint. Floyd now over to Leach. Bleachmore at the top of the key. Louis Bleachmore passes it to Floyd. Floyd surveying the floor. And this will be a whistle. This will be a defensive foul. 15. That'll be Josh Pasquarelli will commit to the game's first foul. Jasper Floyd will inbound. Fairfield out of a stack formation. Floyd, the inbounder. He gets it to Yetna on the wing. Yetna hands it to Fields. Fields back to Yetna. Yetna for three. No good. Coming down with the rebound is Daughtry.
Stags not shying away from the three so far, but 0-3 to start the game.
Pasquarelli inside to Allen. Allen guarded by Bleachmore. He's doubled. Collins now. Javon Cooley, corner three is good. Marist up to a 5-0 lead. 17.5 minutes to go in the first half.
Fairfield doubling Allen there, but Marist playmakers getting done there as there's a three by Cooley.
Leach now at the top of the key. Passes it to Floyd on the near wing. Floyd dribbles with his right into the paint. Scoop wave with his left. And Floyd put it up kind of lazily, and he got his own rebound, but his foot was out of bounds when he caught it. So it'll be a turnover. Marist ball.
We saw Marist start slow yesterday. Marist returning the favor, in a sense, to Fairfield.
Dribbling up the court now, Jaden Collins. The freshman out of Edison, New Jersey, had a career-high 20 in their win over Niagara last night to get them here tonight against Fairfield. Jaden Daughtry inside, quick pass. Pasquarelli, the layup is good. 7-0 Marist.
Yeah, Marist being the aggressors here early. As a result, it's resulted in a 7-0 lead.
Caleb Fields now back to Jasper Floyd at the top of the key. Floyd's going to drive with his left. He's going to lay it up. It's heavily deterred. Yetna grabs the board. Yetna goes up, and he puts Fairfield on the board for their first points of the night, 7-2.
Much needed there for Fairfield. Yetna gets it done on the offensive glass. That's two on the board.
So Fairfield removes the donut off the scoreboard at about 16:45 left here in the first half. Max Allen, top of the key. Picks up his dribble, guarded by Fields. Hands it off to Pasquarelli. The All-MAC rookie team selection tried to go back to Allen, but Louis Bleachmore broke up the pass. Bleachmore one-on-one in transition with the easy layup. Louis Bleachmore, that was all number 12.
How about the big man turning defense into offense? Stellar job there.
7-4 is the score. Marist over Fairfield. Jaden Collins now across half court, guarded by Jasper Floyd. Collins hands it off to Pasquarelli, who's going to drive to the paint, spin, get caught in the paint. He's going to pass it back out to Allen, the reset. Allen now drives to the paint. His layup with the right hand is good.
With that combination of speed and force by Max Allen, nothing stopping him there.
9-4, Marist. Jasper Floyd back out to Yetna, top of the key. Yetna spinning. He's going to pass it into Bleachmore. A little bit chaotic. Max Allen's going to break it up. And I think that will remain Fairfield ball, but we're going to have the first official's timeout. 15 minutes, 38 seconds left here in the first half. Marist is off to a 9-4 lead. Do not go anywhere here at Fairfield University Student Radio, 88.5 FM. Welcome back to Fairfield University Student Radio on 88.5 FM. I'm Ryan Camford alongside Andrew Jamison. It is a 9-4 ball game. Marist has the early lead. 15 minutes, 38 seconds left in the first half. Andrew, what have you seen so far that's allowed Marist to get off to the solid start?
Marist has passed up good shots for better shot, Ryan. They are 4 of 4 from the field, have 3 assists. So they are playing selfless basketball right now as a result, out front early.
And what has been the impact of Max Allen?
For Max Allen, he has been an absolute force in this game so far, doing it both on the offensive end and defensive end, just having his way with the Stags defenders.
We have an awesome crowd here on this Friday night. Both schools' main color is red, and it is a sea of red here at Jim Wheeler Boardwalk Hall in Atlantic City, New Jersey on this Friday night. St. Patrick's Day is tomorrow. Stepping onto the floor for Fairfield will be the same starting five: Yetna, Fields, Leach, Bleachmore, and Floyd. And for Marist, we're going to have a change. Jaden Collins remains in the game. Jackson Price will check into the game. We also have Cam Ferris in the game. Isaiah Brickner in the game.
Marist going to their bench early here.
And there's one more. And Jaden Daughtry remains. So three subs. Leach off the inbound, the three. Awry, no good.
Fairfield now 0-4 to start the game from three.
So Jaden Collins with the rebound. Max Allen out of the game now for Marist. Collins dribbled to his right, passes it to Daughtry in the near wing, who gives it back to Price on the top of the key. Brickner now on the far wing, guarded by Bleachmore, is going to pass it to Daughtry in the far corner. Daughtry tries to go baseline, stopped by Floyd. Price thought about a three, thinks better of it. Price now to Cam Ferris. Cam Ferris at the top of the key. Ferris, deep three, as shot clock expired is good. Yeah, Cam Ferris off the bench onto the score sheet.
Marist absolutely red hot to start this game. Feels like everything's going in right now.
12-4 is the score. The Red Foxes over the Stags. Caleb Fields, top of the key, dribble drives with his left, steps back, resets, passes. Jasper Floyd, corner three, is good, and the Stags have their first three of the game.
Anything you can do, I can do better, Ryan. Jasper Floyd, calm, cool, and collected there. Much-needed three for the Stags.
12-7 is the new score now. Lead cut to five, 14 and a half minutes left here in the first half. Jaden Daughtry gives it over to Brickner. Brickner guarded by Floyd near the far wing. He's going to hand it off to Jaden Collins. Collins dribbles back to the top of the key. Collins dribbles to his right, passes it to Cam Ferris. Cam Ferris now guarded by Floyd after a switch. Now back to Collins on the near wing. Skip pass to the corner, another quick pass. Brickner for three, and that was way off. Not even close. That'll be a shot clock violation. Strong defensive possession for the Stags.
Yeah, no, Marist did everything they could with those cross-court passes, but more often than not, Fairfield's going to pick them off. Excellent job there by the Stags.
Subbing into the game is MAAC sixth player of the year, Bryson Goodine. Taking a seat will be Jasper Floyd. Taking a seat for the Marist Red Foxes will be Jaden Daughtry. And checking into the game for the Red Foxes will be Javon Cooley.
Fairfield not shying away from the three-pointers so far, even though a rather lackluster performance in versus Iona.
Fields now. He's going to get it to Goodine. Goodine fresh off the bench. Driving baseline. Spinning. Puts up a layup with the right. Is good.
Not even 1 minute into the game for Goodine. Getting himself on the scoreboard. Nice job there.
12-9 Marist lead. Jaden Collins now crosses over to the far wing. Passes out to Cam Ferris. Cam Ferris guarded by Goodine. Cam Ferris on his pivots was going to do a rainbow pass in the Price. It's stripped by Leach.
Beautiful help defense there. That's three times now Leach has added an extra man there.
Fields in transition. He's going to try to get it inside. That's stolen by Jaden Collins. Jaden Collins in transition. He's going to pass it over to Brickner. Brickner drives baseline. Passes out errantly. Cooley now. Back to Brickner in the corner. Brickner stops. Kicks it out. Cooley now. Cooley on the near wing. Back to Brickner. Brickner thought about shooting and said drives into the paint. Brickner spins, puts up a shot right in front of the free throw line and misses. Bleachmore with the board.
Fairfield, four of their last five. Marist has cooled off here a little bit, missing their last two. Fairfield's cut into the lead. Now it's three.
Jalen Leach passes over to Goodine. Goodine at the top of the key. Goodine dribbles with his right, guarded by Brickner. Back over to Yetna. Now Fields on the near wing. Fields gets a screen for Bleachmore, dribbles to his left. Fields now driving with his right to the paint. Scoop layup with the right is good. Gets the bounce.
Saucy finish there by Caleb Fields with the crafty movement there. Stags only down one.
The grad student cuts the lead to one. 7-0 run for the Stags. 12-11 is the score. 12 minutes, 35 seconds left in the first half. Jaden Collins dribbles to the near wing. Hands off to Brickner. Brickner now to Price. Over to Cooley in the near wing now. Cooley back to Price. Over to Collins. Collins on the far wing, guarded by Leach. He's going to get a screen. Collins now dribbles to the top of the key, guarded by Yetna. That's a mismatch. Collins dribbles left, pull-up jumper, no good. Offensive rebound. It's a tie-up between Price and Yetna. The possession arrow will go to Fairfield this time, so it'll be Fairfield ball.
Great job there by Fairfield defensively. Marist on a 2.5-minute scoring drought nearly. Fairfield on a 7-0 run as a result in their last 2.5 minutes, and 3 of 3 from the as in their last field goals overall.
Peyton Smith, the freshman, checking into the game for Alexis Yetna. Two substitutions for Marist. Jackson Price and Jaden Collins take a seat. Entering back into the game is Josh Pasquarelli and Max Allen. Goodine dribbles. Passes over to Leach. Leach now in the near wing. He gets a screen from Smith. Leach drives it to the paint. Passes to Smith. Smith, as he's fouled, no good. The foul was committed by Isaiah Brickner.
That'll be Marist. That'll be Brickner's first foul. Team's second.
So that will take us into an official timeout. So Peyton Smith will shoot his free throws momentarily. Do not go anywhere, folks. Marist has a 12-11 lead. 11 minutes, 53 seconds left. Stay right here with us on Fairfield University Student Radio, 88.5 FM. Welcome back to Fairfield University Student Radio at 88.5 FM. I'm Ryan Camp alongside Andrew Jameson. We are in Atlantic City, Jim Whelan Boardwalk Hall, where the number 2-seeded Fairfield Stags are battling with the number 3 Marist Red Foxes for a date with St. Peter's in the championship game tomorrow night. Peyton Smith will go to the line to shoot 2 free throws on the season. Peyton Smith is 73.9% free throw shooter for the Stags, and Smith on the season has really was thrust into the starting role very early on due to injuries on the other team, as Smith makes the first to tie the game at 12. And then in the first game, in the second game against Iona, Smith got hurt in the first minute of the game. And since then, others have returned and his minutes have diminished. But he came on in a stint the other game against Iona and played very well. Smith goes 2 for 2 at the line to give Fairfield their first lead of the game, with 11 minutes and 53 seconds left.
Any contribution the Stags will take, they will take from anybody, Ryan.
Max Allen dribbling the ball up, and we have a whistle. And this appears to be an official issue, something with the clock. So inbounding the ball will be Cam Ferris. The 5 for Marist is Cam Ferris, Isaiah Brickmore, Josh Pasquarelli, Max Allen, and Javon Cooley. For the Stags, it's Bryson Goodine, Jalen Leach, Caleb Fields, Peyton Smith, and Louis Bleachmore. Brickner now with the ball on the logo, dribbles, guarded by Leach. Leach with 3 steals in the early going. He's going to give it over to Cam Ferris. Now Max Allen at the top of the key, guarded by Smith, who goes to pass in. Instant pass is deflected by Fields. Jalen Leach gets it. Pass up to Peyton Smith. It's good. Leach with the vision throws a dot up to the freshman Smith for the easy 2, 15-12, Fairfield over Marist.
Great defense leads to great offense there, Ryan. Stags up 3.
Isaiah Brickner now spinning, driving on Leach, passes it to the corner. Javon Cooley, corner 3. This game is tied, 15-15. 11 minutes, 10 seconds left.
Teams are trading momentum with each basket. We've got a back-and-forth game here so far.
Goodine passes it to Leach at the top of the key, who gives it to Fields on the near wing. Fields dribbles with his right, step back three at the top of the key is good. Caleb Fields, the 1,000-point scorer, who set a career high in threes against Marist in the first matchup, is hot.
Stags are finding their groove offensively, five of their last five from the court.
Pace is picking up. Isaiah Brickner finds Cam Ferris on the far wing, guarded by Fields. Ferris now passes cross-court. Cooley, another three. And Cooley's good. Javon Cooley with three threes in the early going to tie the game up at 18.
Looking like a three-point contest out there, Ryan. These teams are trading buckets all night.
Goodine, top of the key, drives in with his left, passes back out. Peyton Smith, the center, the three. No good. Javon Cooley hauls in the rebound. Cam Ferris now dribbles up the court. Ferris hands it off to Pascarelli. The All-MAC unanimous rookie team nomination gives it back to Ferris. Inside to Allen, who's got a mismatch, who passes into a cutting Pascarelli. Good defense by Leach. It's tipped and the rebound corralled by Goodine.
Way to keep his hands up there, not draw the foul.
Ooh, Cam Ferris tried to pick off the pass. It said Leach gets it, but his three is off. Cooley with another rebound. Isaiah Brickner now. Brickner working into the paint. Scoop play up with the left. Bounces off. Allen can't put the rebound back. Cooley had it, but is fouled. So on their third attempt, Javon Cooley's going to draw a foul, and he will head to the line for a pair. Cooley, red hot from deep so far.
Yeah, and that's going to be a problem for Marist. Has got to keep, Fairfield has to keep up with Marist and contest on the perimeter. Otherwise, Cooley's going to make you pay. Three early three-pointers just about halfway through this first half.
Javon Cooley on the season shooting an excellent 84.8% from the line. Actually, they're going to rule that foul on the floor. So instead, it'll be Cam Ferris inbounding, who's going to give it to Jackson Price, who just checked back in the game. Ferris now in the corner. Ferris guarded by Smith. Ferris smothered by Smith, gets it over to Price. Price now hands it off. Jaden Daughtry also just checked back in the game. Throws a rainbow in for Price, but Price is bothered by Leach. Price and Goodine grabs the rebound and pushing the pace. Goodine, scoop layup, and that's rejected by Daughtry. Isaiah Brickner now in a one-on-one with Caleb Fields, and Fields is going to foul him. And not only do we have a foul, but the referee just went down and is in pain. So we have a lot going on right now. Isaiah Brickner was all alone with Fields, and Fields was fouling him to not give him an easy two. But away from the play, the referee went down and grabbed the back of his leg. So we're going to step away for a moment, and we'll be back soon. It might be a clear path. Welcome back here to Fairfield University Student Radio at 88.5 FM. So to recap what just happened, a lot happened. Back and forth play, we had a referee go down who is now up and walking with a limp, which is a very good sign. But the referees, I'm not sure if they were at the scores table because they were reviewing if it was a clear path foul on Caleb Fields or if it was just a traditional foul. So this is an official's timeout regardless. The referee appears to be moving okay. We'll see if he can continue going on. But regardless, Andrew, the pace has picked up in a major way. The score is 18-18, 9 minutes and 22 seconds left here in half number one. What have you seen in the last 5 minutes of play?
Feels like forever ago. This game was 9-4, Ryan, and let alone Fairfield is heated up, but also Marist is keep chomping away at the scoreboard, matching their momentum and taking it right back. Number 23, Javon Cooley, has three three-pointers, absolutely taking momentum and giving it to Marist. So anything Fairfield is doing, Marist is matching it right back.
Javon Cooley is an impressive 3-for-3 from deep to start. And as a team, Marist is 4-from-5 from deep to start the game and shooting 50% from the field as a whole. Now, it looks like we are going to have a referee substitution. So, in these tournament games, there are four referees. One sits at the score table, and three are on the court. The one at the scores table is going to get up and get loose, and the one who is injured will take his seat at the scores table. So we're going to take another break while they sort this. We'll be right back here at WVOF. Welcome back here at Student at Fairfield University, Student Radio 88.5 FM. I'm Ryan Camford alongside Andrew Jameson, and we just had a stop to what was a dizzying pace. So the referee who was injured is now done for the day. We have three referees still on the court. The one that was on the scores table has entered the court. We also have some substitutions for the Fairfield Stags. James Johns Jr. will check in for the first time today. Peyton Smith remains in the game along with Jalen Leach, Bryson Goodine, and Caleb Fields. Now, stepping up to the line to shoot free throws, as we mentioned earlier, Javon Cooley, who has been red hot from behind the arc, he will not be stepping up. Stepping up to the line instead will be Isaiah Brickner. Isaiah Brickner shooting 65.1% from the free throw line on the season. And as a team, Marist only shoots 69.2% from the free throw line. So it'll be Brickner for two. In the game with Brickner will be Cam Ferris, Jackson Price, Jaden Daughtry, and Javon Cooley. On the seat, on the bench, Jaden Collins and Max Allen. Brickner makes the first to give Marist a 19-18 lead with 9 minutes and 22 seconds left in the first half.
Leading score for the Red Foxes, Cooley has 9.
Both teams have 2 team fouls so far. Brickner makes 2 of 2. So Marist with a 20-18 lead. Caleb Fields dribbles up. Passes the Goodine on the near wing, who gives it to James John Jr. at the top of the key. Caleb Fields far wing now. Fields finds Jalen Leach at the top of the key. Jalen Leach dribbles to his left, passes the Goodine. Goodine finds James John Jr. in the corner, who pump fakes, drives baseline, and will draw a foul on the way up, but James John Jr. went down hard. I believe Javon Cooley will be the culprit for the call.
Hoping James Johns Jr. is okay. Landed on his elbow there awkwardly.
It looked like Johns Jr. was going up for the slam. So that'll be the first personal on Cooley. James Johns Jr. on the year, a 51.7% free throw shooter from the line. James Johns Jr., a sophomore, 6'6", 200 pounds out of Claymont, Delaware. He makes the first of two.
Fairfield now 3 of 3 from the line on the game. Marist 2 of 2.
James John Jr., someone who received a lot of starts earlier in the year but has seen his playing time diminish as the season's gone on due to people returning from injuries. He misses the second of two free throws. So Marist maintains a 20-19 lead, 8 minutes, 53 seconds and rolling left here in the first half at Jim Whelan Boardwalk Hall in Atlantic City. Jackson Price backing down Peyton Smith. Hands it off to Javon Cooley. Javon Cooley, top of the key, three, and why not? Javon Cooley, 4-for-4 from deep, nails the three, 23-19, Marist.
Fairfield cannot afford to give him any separation. He's going to knock it down as he has all night.
Caleb Fields now driving into the paint with his right, spinning, pull-up jumper. The bank is closed, but there will be a foul on the floor on Marist. So Fields misses the shot, but the ball will remain with Fairfield with the foul on the floor.
Marist absolutely scorching from the three-point arc as they are 5 of 6 from 3. Javon Cooley having 4 of those himself.
Goodeye now over to Fields. Fields on the far wing, looking for a screen from Smith, gets it. Fields now back over to Floyd. Goodeye on the near wing now. Goodeye dribbles with his right, dribbles into the paint, goes up with the right, off the backboard, no good. Rebound by Cooley. Cooley now hounded by Goodeye up the court, but gets separation and hands it off to the freshman, Jaden Collins. Collins now, just past the 8-minute mark here in the first half. Marist up 4. Collins dribbles to his right, gets a screen from Allen. Cross-court pass into the corner. Cam Ferris is going to be fouled as he drove baseline. James Johns Jr., the one who committed the foul.
Yeah, and Fairfield just have 3 team fouls on the game. Nonetheless, discipline emphasized here is you cannot afford to give Marist and allow any extra opportunities and allow them to pad their lead.
Inbounding the ball for Marist will be Jaden Collins. Collins sending the guys in motion. Rainbow pass to Allen. Max Allen guarded by Peyton Smith. Allen tries to drive with his left. Smith holds. Peyton Smith holding on Allen. They try to get backside help to no avail. They get it out to Jaden Daughtry. His pull-up jumper from the free throw line elbow, no good. Rebound, Goodine, who's going to give it over to Jasper Floyd. Floyd, James John Jr., Fields, to Goodine, top of the key. Goodine drives with his left, pins it back out to James John Jr. John Jr. drives, goes up the right. He's rejected by Cooley. Gets his own rebound, pops out to Smith, who's going to reset the Floyd. 10 seconds left on the shot clock. Floyd dribbles in with his right, steps back out. Peyton Smith now on the wing, driving on Allen. Fadeaway baseline jumper off the top of the backboard, no good.
Not a smart shot there with Max Allen smothering Smith.
Jaden Collins now is going to go right by Jasper Floyd with an easy layup. You don't see that happen a lot, and Chris Casey's going to take a timeout.
Yeah, Fairfield has struggled offensively as they are 0 for their last 7. Marist has capitalized here completely.
So Marist now is a 6-point lead, 25-19, 7 minutes left in the first half, and we are going to take a break here at Fairfield University Student Radio, 88.5 FM. Do not go anywhere, folks. Welcome back to Fairfield University Student Radio at 88.5 FM. I'm Ryan Camp alongside Andrew Jameson, newly named permanent head coach Chris Casey, called a timeout after Jasper Floyd got blown by freshman Jaden Collins to extend the lead, the Marist lead, up to 6. The 5 on the floor for Fairfield has changed. Alexis Yetna, Louis Bleachmore back in the game alongside Caleb Fields, Bryson Goodine, and Jasper Floyd. The 5 for Marist, Josh Pascarelli, Isaiah Brickner, Max Allen, Jaden Collins, And that was a terrible attempt from three from Fields. That is an air ball, and the Marist folks are letting him know about it.
Fairfield not shy shooting from three. However, it just resulted in 2 of 9, below 25%. Not ideal, as Marist is scorching right now.
Checking into the game for the first time for Marist is Trace Salton, a sophomore out of Lake Oswego, Oregon. So Marist with a 6-point lead. He's going to get it in the Max Allen, who's now guarded by Yetna. Allen hands it off to Pasquarelli. Pasquarelli, three, no good. Collins flies in for the rebound, tips out to Allen. Pasquarelli now is going to pass it out. Salton now is going to give it to Allen. Allen back to Salton. Salton to his left, guarded by Goodine on the near wing, into Allen now. Allen doubled. His pass is tipped, and that'll be off the foot of Josh Pasquarelli. Fairfield ball. So a little bit of a hot potato possession for Marist, but in the event, Fairfield holds.
Yeah, Fairfield has forced 7 turnovers but haven't capitalized from the field, and that's indicative of their field goal percentage. They are just 7 of 21 from the field.
And they had a poor shooting performance from 3 against Iona the other night. Caleb Fields, and we're going to get a stoppage. This will be a defensive foul, and that'll be on Isaiah Brickner. That'll be his second foul. Checking into the game now is Cam Ferris, and Brickner will take a seat.
Fairfield scoreless in their last 3 minutes, trying to crawl into this lead, but first half winds down to a close.
Floyd sends it out to Fields. Fields dribbles his right, passes to Bleachmore. Bleachmore thought about it. The three instead is going to back down Salton, who's going to give it to Yetna. Yetna, top of the key, three. The lefty does not get the bounce. Cam Ferris soars in for the rebound and grabs it for the Red Foxes. Ferris now pushing the pace. Going to get over to Jaden Collins, who goes inside to Allen. Allen goes up for the layup, is good.
He's just too strong down there, Ryan. Max Allen making defenders jump left and right, waiting for the right moment to strike.
27-19, Marist over Fairfield. Louis Bleachmore hands off to Jasper Floyd, who sends it over to Goodine. Goodine, deep three on the near wing. Off the front of the rim, no good. Rebound kept alive. Loose ball is going to be grabbed by Salton. Jaden Collins now. Collins is going to get past midcourt, guarded by Goodine. Jalen Leach ready to check back in for Fairfield. Collins now in the near wing, guarded by Yetna. Allen now working on Caleb Fields. Cam Ferris, deep three, it's good! Cam Ferris hits three to the dome as Marist is up 30-19 with 5 minutes left, and we're going to have another timeout from Chris Casey.
Scoring is contagious right now from Marist, Ryan. They're on a 15-1 run over their last almost 6 minutes. Fairfield, on the other hand, 0 of their last 10 and a 4-minute scoring drought. Not ideal, to say the least.
Chris Casey trying to stop the bleeding. We're going to take a break. Do not go anywhere here at Fairfield University Student Radio 88.5 FM. Welcome back to Fairfield University Student Radio 88.5 FM. I'm Ryan Canfield. He's Andrew Jameson. Andrew, Marist has a 30-19 lead. What is going on?
It's a tell of two tales right now, especially from three-point range and rebounding, Ryan. Marist is 6 of 8, absolutely scorching from the field. Fairfield 2 of 11 from 3, not ideal to say the least. And Marist is passing the ball. 8 assists on 11 field goals. Fairfield just 1 assist on 7 field goals. And Fairfield is losing the battle of the board 16-8 right now.
So Jalen Leach is checking back into the game for the Stags as they get their first team All-MAC player, no longer taking a seat. Caleb Fields passes it to Alexis Yetna, who's going to hand it off to Floyd. Floyd drives in with the left. Scoop layup, it's good.
Casey definitely placed a point of emphasis on being aggressive and being the aggressors from this point out. Great start there by Floyd.
30-21 Marist, 4 minutes 40 seconds left in the first half. Jaden Collins hands it off to Pasquarelli. Pasquarelli dribbles to his right to the top of the key, now hounded by Yetna, who's going to pass inside to Max Allen. Max Allen guarded by Floyd. Backside help for Fields, forces a steal, but they're going to call a foul on Fields. Actually, they're going to call the foul on Floyd. It'll be Jasper Floyd for a reach. That will be his first personal. the fourth team foul for Fairfield.
Yeah, and it's vital here that Fairfield establishes a defensive tone, trying to claw back into this game and build some momentum as the half comes to a close.
Max Allen inbounds to Sultan, who immediately gives it to Collins. Collins dribbles to the top of the key, inside to Allen, working on Yetna. Allen now calls over Cam Ferris. Cam Ferris for three, way off. Yetna disturbed the shot, and Goodine with the box out. That'll be Fairfield ball.
Appears Fairfield may have gotten lucky there with the call. Could have sworn from this angle it went off of Goodine's knee. Nonetheless, Fairfield will take it.
So Jasper Floyd dribbles it up the court. Fairfield trying to cut into a 9-point deficit. Floyd now dribbles into the paint. Crossover move, working on Max Allen. The lefty layup, no good. Alexis Yetna grabs the O-board and immediately puts it back in.
Yetna is right there where he needs to be at the right time. Stags on a 4-0 run here out of the timeout.
30-23 now. Jaden Collins hands it over to Cam Ferris. Cam Ferris drives, backs out, goes to his left. He's going to hand off to Pascarelli. Pascarelli back to Ferris on the far wing. He's guarded by Floyd. Ferris still on the far wing. Way cross-court pass over to Sultan. Sultan now working on Leach. Shot clock down to five. Sultan back to Allen, top of the key. Allen, deep three, and that's an air ball. That's the wrong kind of nothing but net, folks.
Great stop there by the Stags defensively. The pep band's back into it. The crowd's back into it. The bench is excited. Nice real run here for the Stags to get some momentum back.
So after the timeout, it's four unanswered for the Stags. 30-23 is the score. Now, Andrew, we saw earlier in the day, actually, first of all, Fairfield was the only team left in the tournament going to the semifinals that both the men and the women's both in. We saw the women's earlier advance in dominant fashion into the championship game. What did you see out of the Fairfield women today?
And, you know, they were absolutely dominant from start to finish. Their offense struggled in that quarterfinal round against Ryder. However, they had a nice window to work out some mechanics and recover. As a result, they scored 77 en route to a 16-point victory over Canisius here today.
So tomorrow afternoon at 3:30, Logan Rundy, who is our incredible stats person tonight, along with Andrew, will have the call for the women's game tomorrow. But first and foremost, there's 3 minutes and 34 seconds left. Marist is up 7, 30-23. Fairfield struggling to shoot, going on a nice little run after the timeout. What are you expecting as a counter adjustment for Marist here?
Marist has got to back down on the fouls, play aggressive, but aggressively disciplined. They have 5 team fouls. If they get 2 more, Fairfield's going to the line, and Fairfield was clutch in that game against Iona, and it is a big reason why they won that. If you're Marist, you cannot afford to give Fairfield more points than they currently have.
Now, Andrew, I'm going to take a moment and just talk about the disparity between these two teams. I'm going to name the 5 starters for Marist. Jaden Collins, freshman. Jaden Daughtry, sophomore. Max Allen, sophomore. Josh Pascarelli, freshman. Javon Cooley, grad student. A very young Marist team. Now, on the Fairfield side, Caleb Fields, grad student. Jaden Leach, senior. Jasper Floyd, junior. Alexis Yetna, grad student. Louis Bleachmore, senior. What the Marist has in youth, the Stags have an experience.
Both teams thrive in different ways here. Marist is a blend of youth and some veteran experience. Fairfield is primarily veteran experience. Nonetheless, both these teams here meet in the quarterfinal round. Have to give props to both head coaches, John Dunn in his 6th season at Marist, and the newly named head coach, Chris Casey, in his 1st season at Fairfield as the head coach.
So Max Allen, this is his 1st season at Marist. He transferred out of San Jose State last year, and as I mentioned earlier, he's named second team All-MAC and leads Marist with 11.9 points per game. So it'll be Fairfield ball, 3 minutes 34 seconds left as play has resumed. Marist up 30-23. Caleb Fields hands it over to Jasper Floyd. Floyd in the game for Bleachmore, passes it to Fields. Fields on the far wing, dribbles with his left, is going to center things back out. Goodeye now, immediately to Leach. Leach dribbles to the top of the key. Leach now drives. He's going to go up. Contested layup. He's going to be fouled. That's going to be an offensive foul. Max Allen draws the charge.
Looked like Allen didn't have his feet set there from this angle. Nonetheless, a costly turnover there for Stags trying to cut into this lead.
And as you see in the replay, his feet were set, and he was out of the box. That is for sure a charge. 3 minutes, 13 seconds now left. Both teams with 5 team fouls. They're mopping the floor after the 6'9 Max Allen fell backwards. Jaden Collins now dribbles up the court. He's going to hand it off to Cam Ferris. Cam Ferris now is going to get a screen from Allen. Instead, go the other way. Bounce pass. Cooley, good defense by Leach. The rebound's going to go into the hand of Goodine. Goodine now passes over to Leach. Leach dribbles to his left. Fields on the near wing. Fields dribbling to the top of the key, and that'll be a foul on the freshman, Jaden Collins.
Collins going toe-to-toe with Fields in terms of speed. Caleb Fields just creating enough a separation to draw the foul on Collins there.
So checking out of the game will be Pascarelli for Marist. Checking back into the game will be Jaden Daughtry. That was the first personal foul on Collins. The next foul on Marist will send Fairfield to the line. Leach the inbounder. Looking for Goodine, pumps, and eventually gives it to him. Goodine now, Floyd, near wing. Looking for Leach, gets it to him. Leach, top of the key, Fields, near wing now. Fields, top of the key, passes back, Floyd. Floyd on the near wing. Floyd, driving on Collins, spinning, goes up with the left, the bounce, no good. Coming down the rebound, Joe Cooley, but Jasper Floyd steals it right back.
Pickpocket there by Floyd, heads up play.
And we have a whistle. And this appears to be an officials thing, whether it's resetting the shot clock. They're debating if they should reset the shot clock. And the shot clock's getting reset to 28 seconds. 2 minutes, 29 seconds left here in half number one.
Look at some of the advanced metrics from the game so far. Marist shooting 50% from the field, 60% from three. Fairfield, conversely, just 34% from the field, 18 from three.
Fields now gets the inbound. He's going to go with his left hand. Step back three is short. Rebound tipped out to Leach. Leach's second attempt blocked. Yetna had a third attempt. That was blocked. Good defense from the Red Foxes. It will remain Fairfield ball.
Nothing's getting through that Marist paint defense there. Two blocks on that possession. Fairfield had two offensive rebounds, but to no avail.
So inbounding the ball will be Caleb Fields now. The five on the field, on the court, remain Leach, Yetna, Goodine, Floyd, and Fields. For Marist, Ferris, Daughtry, Cooley, Allen, and Collins. Goodine now. Goodine driving with his right on the far wing. He's going to go up, and that's swatted by Cooley, and that'll be a charge. Max Allen, once again, has drawn another charge.
Marist playing absolutely clutch defense here down the stretch.
Actually, excuse me, that was Jaden Collins who drew the charge. So back-to-back possessions now, where the Fairfield Stags have charged into a Red Fox. Checking out of the game will be Bryson Goodine. Checking back into the game for Fairfield, Louis Bleachmore. 2 minutes, 6 seconds left here in the first half. Collins will get the inbound. Fairfield doing a soft press. Collins now passes it over on the near wing to Daughtry. Daughtry inside to Allen. Allen working on Yetna. He's going to go up with the left, and he's going to get that all day long.
Nice spin move there by Allen to create separation off of Yetna. Easy two there.
32-23 is the score. A minute 42 left and rolling here in the first half. Bleachmore's going to give it to Fields. Fields standing on the logo. Fields driving it with the left around Allen. Goes up with a layup, and that's swatted away, but that'll be a foul on Max Allen. That'll be Allen's first personal, and going to the line will be Caleb Fields. Fields, the grad student, a 75.9% free throw shooter. He transferred over from Bowling Green State University after getting injured in his sophomore year. He didn't play his junior year. Last year for the Stags, started every single game but one as he nails the first free throw. The only game he didn't start was senior day. He averaged 11 points for the Stags, and this season has stepped up his game in a big way. He's the second leading scorer for the Stags this season behind Jaden Leach, and has given the Stags a veteran backcourt that it cannot be rivaled by really anyone in the MAAC, as he makes the second of two. So 32-25 is the score now. A minute 30 left. Breaking the press now is Marist. Max Allen driving. He's going to kick it back out. Cam Ferris pumps for three. Instead, he's going to drive. Get Bleachmore in the air. Tries to draw a foul, but that was great defense by Bleachmore.
Yeah,
Jasper Floyd grabs
that.
The board. Floyd now is going to get it over to Leach in the corner. Leach drives baseline. In the paint, kicks it back out. Caleb Fields for three. It's good! 32-28.
Caleb Fields with the last 5 points for the Stags. This lead is all of a sudden four.
Jaden Collins racing up the court. Under a minute to go left in the first half. Cam Ferris hands it off to Collins. Collins at the top of the key. The Fairfield faithful getting loud for the first time in a long time. Collins looking for a screen. He's going to pass it over to Cam Ferris, who calls a timeout. 32-28 is the score. 49.5 seconds left. Marist takes their first timeout of the game. Stay right here, folks. We'll be right back. Welcome back to Fairfield University Student Radio 88.5 FM. I'm Ryan Camp alongside Andrew Jameson. We're at Jim Whelan Boardwalk Hall in Atlantic City, New Jersey, where the number 2-seeded Fairfield Stags are down 4 to the number 3-seeded Marist Red Foxes with a chance to go to the MAAC championship game on the line. Marist just took a timeout after Fairfield has come out and cut the lead back down to 4 again. Inbounding the ball will be Cam Ferris. The five on the floor for Marist. Cam Ferris, Jaden Collins, Jaden Daughtry, Max Allen, and Javon Cooley. For the Stags, it's Jasper Floyd, Caleb Field, Jalen Leach, Alexis Yetna, and Louis Bleachmore. Doubling Collins at half court. They have him caught, and it's a turnover. The pass is to Alexis Yetna, who finds Louis Bleachmore, and Bleachmore gets a layup. It was a goaltend anyway, but it went down.
Great defense leads to great offense there, Ryan. Fairfield is up to 6 steals now on the game. Textbook defense from start to finish. Every man contributed on that possession.
So Jaden Collins, the press had him flustered and sent the pass right to Alexis Yetna. 32-30 is the score. Collins over to Cam Ferris. Cam Ferris being forced backcourt is going to pass it over to Collins. Collins to Allen. Allen now back to Collins. Collins settling things down. 23 seconds left. Shot clock, about 8-second difference with game clock. Collins over to Ferris. Inside to Allen. Allen working on Yetna, spinning the hook with the right hand, no good. There's 12 seconds left. Fairfield's going to hold for the final shot.
Fairfield on a 7-0 run in the last minute here.
Caleb Field taking it up the court. Fields driving with his left hand. Step back three for the lead, no good. And that was not even close. Daughtry gets the rebound. So we will go into the second half. Marist with a 32-30 lead, with Fairfield with a push there at the end of the first half. Andrew, we've had a good one so far. We'll be back a little before the second half begins to give our thoughts on the first half and what to look for in the second half. Do not go anywhere. I'm Ryan Camp alongside Andrew Jameson. We've got a good one here at Fairfield University Student Radio, 88.5 FM.
Mary McGuire, be my fairy to the world, be my very own constellation. A teenage bride with a baby inside, getting high on information. And buy me a star on a boulevard, it's Californication. destruction leads to a very rough road, but it also breeds creation. An earthquake's out to a girl's guitar, that's just another good vibration. And tidal waves couldn't save the world from
It starts with one thing. I don't know why. It doesn't even matter how hard you try. Keep that in mind. I'm designed to try to explain in due time. All I know, time is a valuable thing. Watch it fly by as the pendulum swings. Watch it count down to the end of the day. The clock takes life away. It's so unreal. Didn't look out below. Watch the time go right out the window. Trying to hold on to, didn't even know. I wasted it all just to watch you go. I kept everything inside, and even though I tried, it all fell apart. What it meant to be will eventually be a memory of a time I tried so hard and got so far. But in the end, it doesn't even matter. I had to fall to lose it all.
Hello and welcome back to Fairfield University Student Radio 88.5 FM. I'm Ryan Canfield, he's Andrew Jameson, and we have a great one here at Jim Whelan Boardwalk Hall, Atlantic City. The Stags cut an 11-point lead down to 2 with a chance to take the lead going into the half. It's a 32-30 game, Marist over Fairfield. Andrew, what have you seen in the early going?
Well, Marist started out red hot. They have still been red hot. They're shooting 60% from 3 and 46% from the field. 8 turnovers are a big reason, though, why Fairfield is still in this game. Fairfield has 8 points off turnovers, whereas Marist has just 2. And Fairfield is holding their own on the battle of the boards, where it is just even. But shooting numbers indicate that Fairfield is fortunate to be in this game, in a sense.
Absolutely. Fairfield is shooting 34% from the field, 21.4% from 3, 83% from the free throw line. That's huge. In these types of games, you gotta make your free throws. And on the other side, as you mentioned, Marist is shooting a scalding 60% from 3. They're 6 of 10 from beyond the arc. They're 12 of 16 overall, shooting a very solid 46% from the field, and they have made both of their free throws. Now, Marist on the year only scores about 64.8 points per game, and right now they're on pace for just about that. They've gotten what they've won out of Fairfield, which is how, when their victory, they won. They've gotten Fairfield to play their game. And Fairfield, we know their style is run and gun. They thrive on their four guards: Floyd, Leach, Goodine, Johns Jr. Those are their four. And look, as you mentioned earlier, Fairfield is the only team, the only program, to have both the men and the women in the semifinals. The men are trying to make it to be the only program to have two teams in the finals with a date with St. Peter's tomorrow night. Andrew, what does Fairfield need to do to cut this lead and make it tied, and not only that, but when zero's in the clock, to make sure that they're in the lead?
And in order for the men to meet the women in the finals, as both Stags are hoping to be in the finals and the only team to do so, they got to spread the ball out more and just share the wealth a little bit. Fairfield only has 4 assists on 11 field goals. If you look at Marist, they have 9 assists on 12 field goals. We talked about the women from time to time again this season, passing up good shots for better shots. Marist has done that and did that early on in the first half. Fairfield has to do that if they want to cut into the lead and build one.
Major key for Fairfield, we mentioned earlier, Jaden Leach, all MAAC first team. He is the Stags' leading scorer coming into this game, 16.4 points. He had 22 last game. 15 of his 22 came in the second half. Andrew, Jaden Leach did not score a single point in the first half.
No, he did not. And, you know, Marist kind of had their way with WVOF yesterday, him and his dominant paint presence. Marist is having their way so far with Jaden Leach. Just 3 shots up for Jaden Leach, and he's played 17 minutes, so it's not like he's not playing at all. He's been there. It's just his presence has been shut down entirely by the Marist Red Foxes. If I'm Coach Chris Casey, I have to put trust in my player, because he is one of the marquee players on this Stags team. It's a big reason why Fairfield is in the position way they are, and in these moments, you have to give them to your best players, and Leach is certainly one of them.
Andrew, I think you said it best earlier. I think Fairfield is fortunate to be in this game. When your best player did not score a single point, and you shot as poorly as you did from the field in the first half, and to only be down 2, I thought Chris Casey's timeouts were incredibly well timed. Now, on the Marist side of things, if we're saying from the Fairfield side how fortunate it is to only be down 2, Marist has got to be a little bit frustrated they're only up 2.
Yeah, well, Marist, anytime you shoot 60% from 3 points, anytime someone shoots 60% from 3 points, you expect a large lead, whether in the 10s or 15s. They're only up 2. for Marist, it's a matter of ball security now. As I mentioned earlier, Marist has 8 turnovers on the game. Those second chance points that Fairfield has are allowing them to stay in this game. They only have a 2-point lead. If they keep turning the ball over, this lead's going to be evaporate before they know it.
Leading the way for Marist, Javon Cooley, 4-for-5 from the field. However, he's made all 4 of his attempts from 3. He's leading the way in scoring with 12 of the 32 Marist points, in addition to snagging 4 boards with a couple of rejections. And Andrew Cooley's a player who has been with Marist his entire career, and his role, as his career has gone on, has continued to grow. Cooley, year in, year out now, his role has grown, and now he's playing impactful minutes for what is the best Marist team in the last 15 years. Marist, Andrew, this is for a program. Marist has not won 18 games in a season since 2007-2008. They have a chance to do something very, very special in John Dunn's 6th season here.
They were knocking on the doorstep last year, as you said, making it all the way to the finals in Atlantic City. Knocking on the doorstep here, up to, have to give credit to Coach John Dunn and his entire coaching staff for the Red Foxes. It's going to be a great second half as we are just about to get underway here. But going back to one of the keys of the game we talked about, we saw when the Stags pressured defensively and implemented a press of their own, they were absolutely dominant in forcing turnovers. Fairfield has to break the ball movement of Marist, force turnovers, and get some transition baskets to build some momentum.
Yeah, and as you mentioned, in these kind of games, you need someone other than your stars to step up and be that guy for you. Javon Cooley, in the season for the Marist Red Foxes, averaged 7.3 points per game. He is 12 at half. Sometimes there are players that just have knack for the big moments, and so far Cooley has proven to be that guy for the Red Foxes.
Yeah, and Fairfield, they have to have that in response to try to get back into this game. Not that they aren't in this game, but build the lead and pad it. Nonetheless, you have to look at guys like Peyton Smith, James Jones Jr., who didn't really put in quality minutes. For example, we were talking about earlier during the halftime, Peyton Smith taking fadeaway shots, that's not his game. He is a dominant paint presence and needs to go back to his roots in a sense and play his best basketball, which is in the paint. James Jones Jr., he just has to be a physical force for the Stags, just asserting his will, forcing turnovers, and contesting Marist shots left and right.
So the Stags will send their starting 5 back onto the court, which is Louis Bleachmore, Caleb Fields, Jasper Floyd, Jalen Leach, and Alexis Yetna. And this time, the Stags will be going from my left to the right. The Marist Red Foxes, on the other hand, will send out Pascarelli, the All-MAC unanimous rookie team selection, Jaden Collins, Max Allen, Jaden Daughtry, and Javon Cooley. So Pascarelli, the inbounder, as Marist will start with the ball. And half number 2 of the MAAC Men's Tournament Semifinals, with a Bertha championship on the line, is underway. Jaden Collins receives the inbound and will cross half court. Collins dribbles to his left. Now back to his right. He's at the top of the key. Collins bounce pass to Cooley. Cooley on the near wing. He's going to give it in to the elbow now. Daughtry guarded by Bleachmore. Daughtry drives to the back. That's swatted away by Bleachmore.
Great
Leach
falling.
Grabs it. Jalen Leach pushing the pace in transition. Pulls up. Passes to Fields. Fields on the far wing. Drives baseline. Scoop play with the right hand. Is good. Is not good, but he draws the foul.
Beautiful cut there by Caleb Fields to create separation off the defender. How about that phenomenal block there by Bleachmore to set the tone and make that play possible?
So there'll be Fields who will go to the line. That'll be Jaden Daughtry, who's the foul. Fields has a chance to tie the game. He made both of his free throws earlier, as we mentioned. He came into the game as a 75.9% free throw shooter. The 1,000-point scorer misses his first free throw.
Fields leads the Stags in scoring tonight with 10, is 3 of 9 from the field, 2 of 6 from 3.
So Fields, looking to salvage his attempt to the charity stripe, does. He gets 1. 32-31 is the score, 19 minutes and 35 seconds left here. Fairfield in a much more aggressive press than they were earlier. Passing for the Red Foxes, they still have not crossed midcourt. Pascarelli now to Allen, quick passing. Collins driving, his layup. Pretty move, the adjustment of midair going up and under with the right hand makes it 34-31.
Crafty nature of Collins there prevailing as he's rewarded with 2.
Jasper Floyd now. Floyd driving inside, working on Allen. He's going to spin back out and reset to the top of the key. Floyd still working on Allen, passes to Leach on the near wing. Leach looking for his first points of the game. Drives with the left. He goes up, and he's going to draw the foul. That'll be Jaden Daughtry. Daughtry's first personal. Marist's second team foul already within the first minute of the second half.
Jaden Leach absolutely eager to get back going and get back on track for the Stags, as he is pivotal in this second half if the Stags want to prevail here tonight.
Jaden Leach is a 90.6% free throw shooter, which leads the MAAC. And if this percentage holds for the rest of Fairfield's season, as Leach makes the first, Jaden Leach will go down holding the highest free throw percentage in Fairfield men's basketball history if this holds. He makes the first to cut the lead to two. Leach's free throw percentage is first in the MAAC, seventh nationally. And of course, as I praise his free throw shooting, he misses the second. The score is 34-32, Marist over the Stags. Jaden Collins sends it over to Daughtry. Back out to Pascarelli. Pascarelli at the top of the key, far wing, now Collins. Collins dribbles to his left. Working over by Bleachmore, passed on to Fields. Pascarelli on the near wing. Inside to Allen, working on Bleachmore. Allen goes up, and the hook shot is good.
Bigger body prepares there, and Allen is, he was able to get that shot off with just enough wiggle room.
36-32 is the score. Louis Bleachmore bounce pass to Leach, who gives it to Fields. Fields gets a screen from Yetna, who drives in, step back, pull up, Jay is good.
Palm coin collected there. Caleb Fields with a nice fade away.
36-34 now. Pascarelli, quick pass up to Daughtry. Daughtry on the far wing, back to Pascarelli. Collins now. Collins on the near wing. Collins surveying the floor, calling out formations. He's going to pass to Javon Cooley. Cooley on the near wing, gets back to Pascarelli at the top of the key, who gives it back to Collins. Collins now dribbles to the top of the key. Collins, crossover, tries the drive, sends it back out to Max Allen. Shot clock winding down. Pascarelli, the three, no good, rebound Floyd.
Nice contest there by Yetna getting there in the nick of time to force a stop.
Leach now on the far wing. Leach driving with his right hand. He goes up with his right hand, no good. Rebound Allen, pushing the pace, Collins. Collins, pull-up jumper. No good, too strong. Fields corrals the board.
Great there, board there by Fields.
Fields now moving with pace. He's going to pass it over Floyd. The three from the near wing is good. And Fairfield has the lead, 37-36.
Much needed there by Floyd to build some momentum as this Fairfield faithful is back into it.
Pass over to Jaden Collins. Fairfield with the one-point lead, 17 minutes and seconds. Pascarelli, the three. He responds, 39-37.
Took the momentum right back. It's a tug-of-war for momentum right now, Ryan.
Fields over to Leach. Leach near the top of the key. He's going to dribble to his left. Pull-up three from Leach. Off, no good. Yet in a try to corral it, instead, Collins took it out of his hands. Maris with a two-point lead. Collins dribbles to the near wing. Picked up his dribble. Get a pass it to Cooley, who gives it right back to Collins. Collins dribbles back to the top of the key. John Dunn calling in a play. Gives it to Max Allen now. Allen trying to drive on Yetna. Driving, spinning his way into the paint. No good. Too uncontrolled. Beautiful. Floyd now moving in transition.
Beautiful defense there by Yetna.
Floyd, pull up three. Off wide. Probably not the smartest shot selection there.
Anticipation got there by Jasper Floyd. The crowd excitement definitely influenced that shot. Could have passed up for a better shot there. Nonetheless, Marist ball here.
Substitutions for Marist. Max Allen taking a seat. Jaden Daughtry taking a seat. Javon Cooley taking a seat. We have Isaiah Brickner, Jackson Price checking into the game for Marist. And pressing still is Fairfield. Collins now. Fairfield rolling with their same five. Breaking the press is Marist. Pascarelli, another three. This time, no good. Getting the rebound is Floyd. Floyd moving quickly. Floyd across half court. Floyd, field, wing, three. No good. Hits the rim. Floyd fights for the rebound, but goes to the hands of Brickner.
Just out
Brickner now
there.
Moving with speed. Brickner, pass. Daughtry, his layup is good.
There's that unselfish basketball by Marist, who now has 13 assists on the game.
41-37 is the score. 15 minutes, 45 seconds left. Fairfield's lead went away very fast. Fields now dribbles, gets it over to Leach. Leach held to just 1 point so far. Floyd pumps. He's going to drive in, get to the Yetna along the baseline. Yetna's shot, no good. Very well contested by Brickner. Brickner now is going to slow things down, and the Marist as a whole, the Red Foxes are going to slow things down. Collins across half court. He's guarded by Floyd. He's going to dribble to the far wing. Pass over to Daughtry. Daughtry inside. Brickner working in the paint. Corner three. Pasquarelli now. It's good. Brickner inside and out finds the open Pasquarelli, and it's a 44-37 lead for Marist.
The freshman there coming through in the clutch to extend the Red Foxes' lead to 7, now on an 8-0 run.
Floyd, top of the key. He's going to find Caleb Fields, guarded by Pasquarelli. Fields goes to his left. He's going to do an up and under layup. It bounces, and it is good.
Caleb Fields has been solid all night. Much needed there from the Stags as they cut the lead to 5.
Caleb Fields, a saving grace for Fairfield with 15 points. Jaden Collins now. Floyd goes for the steal and said he whisses. Collins goes to the rack, misses, gets his own rebound, and that's rejected by Yetna, but they're going to call a foul. And I believe that foul will be on Alexis Yetna. Collins went down hard, but he's up. So this will be officials' timeout. Marist has a 44-39 lead, 14 minutes, 29 seconds left here in the second half. We're going to take a quick break, but don't go anywhere here at Fairfield University Student Radio, 88.5 FM.
Part of your property, remembering all the times you fought with me. I'm surprised it got so. Things aren't the way they were before. You wouldn't even recognize me anymore. Not that you knew me back then, but it all comes back to me in the end. You kept everything inside, and even though I tried, it all fell apart. What it meant to me will eventually be a memory of a time when I tried so hard and got so far.
Welcome back to Fairfield University Student Radio 88.5 FM. I'm Ryan Canfield alongside Andrew Jameson. We are in Atlantic City, Jim Whelan Boardwalk Hall, covering the MAAC men's semifinals game where the number 2-seeded Fairfield Stags face a 5-point deficit to the number 3-seeded Marist Red Foxes.
Yeah, no, Caleb Fields has really been the saving grace, as you said earlier in the broadcast, for the offense. 15 points. When a player accounts for almost 40% of your points by himself, that goes to show the depth is not there and he's not getting any help. Mainly, we have to look at Jalen Leach, who was a first-team All-MAC honoree, just 1 point. 0-5 shooting, 0-4 from three. He needs to get it going, and he needs to get it going now.
And Fairfield as a whole are having another dismal shooting night. 35% from the field, 22.2% from three. And Andrew, I don't think it's unfair to say this is a team that really does live and die by the three-point shot.
No, they absolutely have all season. We saw in that game against Mount St. Mary's where they were down 16 at halftime. They came raging back. How did they do that? By three-pointers and passing the ball. Fairfield has done neither of those tonight at a high rate, and as a result, they are down 5 with under 15 to go.
So the five on the floor for the Stags will be Bleachmore, Yetna, Floyd, Leach, and Fields. Shooting free throws for the Red Foxes will be Jaden Collins. The freshman is a 65.6% free throw percentage. And he makes the first. The other four alongside Collins on the floor for the Red Foxes are Brickner, Daughtry, Pasquarelli, and Price. And we're just seeing a replay, folks. Max Allen was just getting treatment on his leg on the bench, something to keep an eye on.
Fairfield's got to take advantage, and that advantage has to be taken now.
So Collins makes the second. Fields now over to Floyd on the far wing. Floyd dribbles back to top of the key. Leach Sends it into the far corner, Fields. Fields gets a screen. He's going to pass back out. Yetna. Yetna for three. No good. Leach fighting for the offensive board. Ball still loose. Price grabs it and will hand it over to Jaden Collins.
Fairfield's got to revert from the three-point game sooner rather than later. They're just 4 of 19, and nothing seems to be falling right now.
Jaden Collins worked over by Floyd. He's going to pass it over to Pasquarelli. Pasquarelli left wide open, takes the three, too short off the front of the rim. Long rebound goes to Brickner. Marist getting another possession. Brickner now on the near wing. Thinks about driving, goes back. Floyd guarding him. Brickner dribbling to the top of the key. He's going to pass it to the near wing, Collins. Collins now dribbles with his right into the paint. He's going to try and work on his pivot foot, and that was a very pretty move from the freshman using the backboard to get the easy two.
Yeah, great elusiveness there by Collins to create separation from the defender.
48-39, Marist lead over the Stags, 13 minutes, 15 seconds and rolling. Yetna with the layup, he's fouled. So Yetna will go to the line for two.
Marist on a 12-2 run in their last 3 minutes and 40 seconds. Urgency meter is ticking by the second for Fairfield.
Yetna, a 53.8% free throw shooter, and we're going to have a couple of substitutions here after the first shot. For the Stags, Bryson Goodine and Peyton Smith will check into the game, and checking into the game for Marist will be Cam Ferris and Javon Cooley. Yetna makes the first. Taking a seat for the Stags will be Floyd. Smith will check in for Yetna after he's done shooting. Leaving the game for Marist is Pasquarelli and Daughtry. So the five on the floor now for the Stags will be Goodine, Smith, Fields, Bleachmore, and Leach. And for Marist, it'll be Ferris, Collins, Price, Brickner, and Cooley. Yetna makes the second. Into the game, Peyton Smith.
Two huge free throws there by Yetna. Now you need stops.
48-41 is the score. 13 minutes, 15 seconds here in the second half in Atlantic City with a trip to the MAAC Tournament Championship game on the line. Collins now. Calling for a screen. Guarded by Caleb Fields. Collins now. Bounce pass inside the Price. That'll be a travel. That'll be a travel on Jackson Price.
Marist's ninth turnover on the game. Although Fairfield has four, it has not resulted in a scoreboard advantage and amounted to anything.
So Caleb Fields now dribbling up the court. They need to go on a run if they want to bring this game close again. Fields at the top of the key, passes over to Leach. Leach on the near wing, drives into the paint. Leach spinning, puts up a shot. It's good. Leach's first field goal of the day.
All it takes is one to get some confidence and momentum back. Jalen Leach, we're hoping that's the start of a nice run for him.
48-43 is the score, 12 and a half minutes left. Marist with a five-point lead. Brickner now picks up his dribble on the far wing. He's caught, is going to hand it off to Cam Ferris. Ferris now guarded by Peyton Smith. That's a mismatch. Ferris gets him up in the air, drives it to the paint, loses control, but that'll be a foul. That will be a foul on Peyton Smith. And this will be a shooting foul. So that is the first personal on Peyton Smith, the second team foul for Fairfield.
Nice patience there by Ferris to wait for the right moment to draw the foul. As a result, he's going to line for two.
Ferris 8 for 10, 80% at the free throw line during the regular season. His first shot, nothing but net. 49-43 now, 6-point lead for Marist.
Marist perfect from the line so far, 5 of 5.
In these tight games, when the margin error is razor thin, you have to be able to nail your free throws, and Marist has done that so far. Cam Ferris looking to make him go 6 for 6 as a team. He does. So Ferris hits both. The lead is extended back up to 7, 50-43 is the score. Fields dribbling on the far wing, inside, now baseline. He's going to pass it out, Goodine. Goodine on the far wing. Goodine guarded by Ferris. He's going to try and dribble drive. Goodine pulls up, pull-up jumper, rattles around, no good. Tip back up, no good. Cam Ferris holds in the board. Isaiah Brickner now for Marist. Brickner dribbles near the near wing. Calling for somebody. Guarded by Louis Bleachmore. Now Brickner drives with his left. Now with his right into the paint, he loses control of the ball. Goodine has it. Goodine to Leach. Leach in transition. Into the rack. Now hands it off. Dumps it off for Peyton Smith. And that's an and one. A beautiful little handoff to Peyton Smith with the easy layup and gets the foul.
Leach might not be getting it on the scoreboard tonight. However, he's setting his teammates up beautifully as no different there. Peyton Smith going to the line for a three-point play.
But Peyton Smith's three-point play is going to have to wait until after the official's timeout. We will be right back. Marist 50, Fairfield 45. Do not go anywhere. Welcome back to Atlantic City. We are at Jim Whelan Boardwalk Hall. The Fairfield Stags have a five-point deficit to the Marist Red Foxes. I'm Ryan Canford alongside Andrew Jamison. Peyton Smith looking to complete the three-point play. Now, something I want to keep an eye on. We have not seen Max Allen in a little bit. He's remained on the bench. He was getting treatment on his legs earlier. It's something we should just keep track of for the rest of the game. Now, Peyton Smith, he's 2-for-2 from the line today, 73.9% free throw shooter coming into today.
Number 33, Peyton Smith.
The freshman, 6'10", 250 pounds out of Hudson Falls, New York, started every game for Fairfield until he got hurt against Iona. His free throw rattles around and falls, so the Marist lead cut to 4, 50-46.
Need stops now, Ryan, you need stops.
11 minutes, 35 seconds left. Jaden Collins dribbles. Going to pass it over to Cam Ferris. Ferris on the near wing, guarded by Smith. Ferris, crossover, into the paint, kicks it back out. Price for three. The price is right. Jackson Price finds the bottom of the net. The Marist lead goes back up to 7.
Seems like Fairfield, anytime they have momentum, Marist just takes it right back.
Goodeye now gives it to Leach. Leach finds Fields. Fields on the far wing, gets a screen for Bleachmore. Drives, baseline, bounce pass in. Smith, layup is good. Nice pass from Caleb Fields.
The freshman stepping up in a huge way here. Second for the Stags in scoring with 9 tonight.
So Jaden Collins now. Dribbling at the top. Not moving with a whole lot of pace, willing to let the clock go. Collins driving to the paint hard. His layup with the left hand is good. The burst from the freshman.
Yeah, and that burst of energy created that separation.
Fairfield moving with pace. Peyton Smith working on the low box, spinning. Not winning. It goes off the front of the rim and into the hands of Cam Ferris. Ferris now dribbling, working on Fields. He's going to drive into the paint. He's going to recalibrate and go back out. Ferris, Collins now. Collins on the far wing. Dribbling back to center court. Jaden Collins, skip pass over to Javon Cooley. Javon Cooley drives to the paint. His layup no good, but that'll be a blocking foul on Peyton Smith. Coming back into the game, Max Allen, along with Jaden Daughtry.
Yeah, Marist has kept up the offensive intensity here in a big way. 3 of 3 from their field goals and 5 of their last 7 overall.
We're going to have a couple substitutions here. Jasper Floyd is going to check back into the game. But stepping up to the line, Javon Cooley. We mentioned how hot he was from three. He's not taken a free throw yet today. On the season, Cooley has nailed 84.8% of his free throws. One of the best marks on the team, he nails his first. 55-40 is the score, taking a seat for Marist. Jackson Price, Isaiah Brickner coming into the game, Max Allen, Jaden Daughtry. Louis Bleachmore taking a seat for the Stags, Jasper Floyd entering. The five for the Stags, Smith, Goodine, Floyd, Leach, Fields, as Cooley nails the second. The five for the Red Foxes, Daughtry, Cooley, Collins, Allen, and Ferris. Leach now. Leach at the top of the key, guarded by Daughtry. Finds Floyd on the far wing. He's going to get a screen. Floyd now back to Leach on the far wing. Dribbles back to the top of the key. Now dribbling into the paint. He's going to jump up. Gets about to Fields. Fields now driving. Fields. Floater. Bounces around the rim. No good. But Fields gets the loose rebound and he gets the layup.
Way to not give up on the play there by Fields, following through for a much-needed two.
Fairfield cuts the lead down to seven. 57-48. Just about 9.5 minutes left until the end of this one. Collins. Dribbles to his left, looks for a handoff. Floyd doesn't allow it. Allen now, freshly into the game, working on Peyton Smith. He picked up his dribble, gets it back out to Cam Farris. Farris, dribbling, step back three. No good off the back of the rim. Into the hands of Leach. Leach, moving with speed. Crossover move into the paint. His layup off the backboard is good. 57-52 now.
Each bucket grows more confidence in Jalen Leach. He is up to 5 on the game.
Jaden Collins now, hands over to Cam Farris. Farris works back, he's guarded by Peyton Smith. Farris now to the far wing, picks up his dribble, skip pass in the corner, Jaden Collins. Collins, that'll be off Jalen Leach's foot. Jalen Leach is looking for a travel, does not get it. It'll remain Marist ball, there's 11 seconds on the shot clock.
Yeah,
Peyton Smith checking out of the game, Alexis getting it back in the game. Cam Farris taking a seat. The All-MAC unanimous rookie selection, Joshua Pasquarelli, back in the game.
Just under 9 minutes here. Marist leads by 5.
Pasquarelli now the inbounder. 11 seconds left on the shot clock. He finds Cooley. Cooley on the near wing, guarded by Goodine. Cooley goes to the top of the key. Now over to Collins. Collins, dribble drive in, spinning. Fade away, free throw line jumper, no good. Jaden Leach with the board. Leach moving with pace. He's going to give it to Fields. Fields, bounce pass inside, broken up by Cooley. Goodine gets the loose ball. Now Fields. Fields on the near wing. Goodine now. Goodine dribble driving into the paint. His layup no good. Yetna fighting for the rebound. He gets the rebound. Alexis Yetna gets a strip, but he's going to draw the foul. The foul will be on Daughtry.
Great hustle there by Yetna, getting that offensive board and drawing the foul. Marist up to 5 team fouls in the second half.
That'll be Daughtry's third personal foul. Excuse me, second personal. Jasper Floyd will be the inbounder. 20 seconds left on the shot clock. 8 minutes, 18 seconds left in this one. Referees making sure there aren't any wet spots on the floor before we resume play. Fairfield in their stack formation. Ball inbounded below the net. Floyd bounce pass into Yetna. Yetna out to Leach. Leach finds Fields. Fields in the corner. Step back. Corner three. Caleb Fields off the front of the rim. No good. Rebound falls into the hands of the freshman, Jaden Collins, who's racing up the court. Collins, guarded by Floyd. About to pass the 8-minute mark here in Atlantic City. Collins, crossover on Floyd. Now on the baseline, he's going to pass it back out. Allen. Allen driving into the paint, and that's going to be a... No, that's going to be a foul on the floor. And that will take us into an official timeout. So we will be right back, folks. We have a berth to the MAAC championship game on the line. Marist is up 57, Fairfield 52. 7 minutes, 54 seconds left. I'm Ryan Canfield. He's Andrew Jameson. We have a good one. Don't go anywhere on Fairfield University Student Radio 88.5 FM. Welcome back to Fairfield University Student Radio. I'm Ryan Canfield alongside Andrew Jameson. We're on 88.5 FM. And we want to thank you for spending part of your Friday evening with us down here in Atlantic City, New Jersey, the Jim Whelan Boardwalk Hall. So, it was a foul on the floor on Max Allen. So, inbounding the ball for Marist will be Isaiah Brittner. The five on the floor for Marist will be Brittner, Allen, Daughtry, Pasquarelli, Cooley. The five on the floor for Fairfield, Goodine, Leach, Fields, Floyd, and Yetna. 20 seconds left in the shot clock, under 8 minutes left in this game, 57-54. Backside help on Allen, but instead of a steal, we'll draw another foul. So that'll be Fairfield's fifth team foul. And that will go on Jasper Floyd, and that's his third personal foul. So here we go again, 7 minutes, 50 seconds left. Inbounding the ball again is Brickner. Brickner holds, gets into the corner is Pasquarelli, who immediately gives it to Allen.
That's a mismatch.
Allen hands off to Pasquarelli. Pasquarelli back down to Allen. Allen outside. Cooley for three. Off the front of the rim. His first miss from three, and that will be a foul on Max Allen. That'll be a loose ball foul. That'll be Allen's second personal, 16 foul for Marist.
Allen is such a threat down low in the paint that he was triple-teamed at one point. Cooley was open. However, you cannot give him that shot if you're Fairfield.
Caleb Fields dribbling up the court, looking to cut into their five-point deficit. Goodine. Goodine dribbles to the far wing, hands off to Fields. Fields dribbles back to the top of the key. He's going to get out the Goodine on the wing. Goodine loses the ball, gets it back. Going to find Caleb Fields in the corner now. Fields guarded by Pasquarelli. Fields drives, loses the ball off his leg. Picked up by Daughtry. Daughtry now on the near wing, guarded by Leach. Daughtry is going to send it back out to Brickner. Brickner calling for a screen. Allen comes over, but Floyd steals it. Floyd steals it. Leach moving in transition. That's going to be a foul on Max Allen. Now, will this be a clear path foul? The Chris Casey, the Fairfield bench, and the Fairfield faith are pleading for it. And there's going to be a substitution. Jaden Collins is going to come in the game for Brickner. That was an unbelievable effort by Floyd to pull off that steal, first of all. But that's Allen's third personal. Floyd now, Goodine. Goodine top of the key, 57-52 is the score. Goodine driving out to Fields now. Fields near the near wing, drives into the paint. Fields, scoop layup, it's good!
Much needed there for Fields. Not the best three-point shooting night for him, trying to get it done by any means.
And that's going to be a foul. So on the inbound pass, Floyd picked off Pasquarelli's pass. But they're going to call a foul on Floyd. So that's Jasper Floyd's fourth personal foul with 6 minutes and 42 seconds left. Both teams now with 6 fouls. The next foul for either team, and we're going to start shooting free throws.
That's tough for Fairfield, especially for Floyd, who has 4 fouls. They're going to have to take a cautious manner here.
So Louis Bleachmore will check into the game for Floyd. And we had a substitution for Marist. Cam Ferris is checking into the game for Pasquarelli. Ferris, the inbounder, Fairfield pressing. Back to Ferris. Hands it off to Collins. Collins now. Marist holds a three-point lead. Guarded by Goodine. Collins over to Cooley. Guarded by Bleachmore on the near wing, who gives it back to Allen. Guarded by Yetna. Collins now back on the near wing. Goodine on him. Collins, top of the key. Ferris. Ferris dribble drives with his right. He's going to use his pivot, and that's rejected by Leach. The rebound swatted out. Cooley tries to save it, throws it back in erratically, and Yetna has it. And that'll be a shot clock violation on Marist.
Out of all the things I could have called, I didn't think shot clock was going to be it. Nonetheless, great defensive stand there by the Stags, particularly Jalen Reach meeting him at the rim. Phenomenal execution there.
So Leach swatted it. The ball pinballed around for enough for the shot clock violation to be called. So Fairfield down 3, just over 6 minutes left, with a chance to tie this game on this possession. Fields, top of the key, drives. He's going to give it to Goodine. Goodine for 3! Rolls around, no good. Max Allen with the rebound.
Everything is right now. There.
Ferris, guarded by Fields. Dribbles to his right. He's at the top of the key. He's going to hand off to Collins. Collins now, the freshman. Scored a career-high 20 last night in the win over Niagara. Collins gets a screen from Allen. Now he's on the Yetna. They get the switch they want. Over to Daughtry in the corner. Daughtry now inside to Allen. And that'll be an offensive foul. Caleb Fields draws the charge on Max Allen, and that is Max Allen's fourth personal foul.
Big-time players make big-time plays. Ryan Caleb Fields with the biggest play of them all so far this game. Max Allen has four fouls. It appears he's going to be taken out here.
He will be. So Jackson Price will check back into the game.
Do not underestimate Price, though. He had 12 points off the bench in that win versus Niagara.
So Fields now dribbles up the court. Bleachmore passes over to Leach. Leach passes back to Fields. Fields on the far wing. Fields gets a screen from Yetna. Fields for three. This game is tied. 57-57. Timeout Marist.
The Fairfield faithful is going crazy, Ryan. Crazy.
Caleb Fields has put this team on his back and willing them and willed them back into this game. 22 points for the 1,000-point scorer. The grad student refuses to let the season end here tonight for the Stags. We're going to take a quick break. Folks, we have a great one. Do not go anywhere on Fairfield University Student Radio, 88.5 FM. Welcome back to Jim Whelan Boardwalk Hall in Atlantic City. I'm Ryan Canfield. He's Andrew Jamison. You're listening to Fairfield University Student Radio, 88.5 FM. And Andrew, Caleb Fields has willed the Stags from multiple significant deficits back to a tie game at 57.
Caleb Fields single-handedly putting his team on his back. 22 points on the game. 8 of 17 from the field. 3 of 9 from 3. Fairfield as a result on a 9-0 run in the last 4.5 minutes. Marist in a little bit of a scoring drought here. It appears Max Allen is going to be checking back into the game for the Red Foxes. I believe he has three fouls now.
The scoreboard was incorrect, so we apologize for that. Allen has three fouls, which is still significant. There's 5 minutes and 12 seconds left. Plenty of time. Now Marist has 17 fouls. So Fairfield, next time they are fouled, will go into the bonus at 1-1. Fairfield with 16 fouls. Both teams have two timeouts left. This has been an outstanding game. We wouldn't have expected anything less between these two teams. The five on the floor for Fairfield will remain the same. Caleb Fields, Bryson Goodine, Jaden Leach, Alexis Yetna, and Louis Bleachmore. There will be 5 minutes and 12 seconds left when this game resumes. It'll be Marist ball. The five on the floor for Marist will be Josh Pascarelli, Jaden Collins, Javon Cooley, Max Allen, and Jaden Daughtry. So the starting five on the floor for Marist.
Fairfield cannot afford to foul here. They're in the bonus. Marist is not. It needs to stay that way, Ryan.
Collins now across half court. Crowd on their feet. Here, Jim Whelan, Boardwalk Hall in Atlantic City with a trip to the championship on the line. Collins dribbles to the near wing. Now to the baseline. Picks up his dribble. Out to Allen on the wing. Allen now picks up his dribble. He's going to give it to Pascarelli. Pascarelli behind the three-point line on the near wing. Crossover move on Yetna. Into the paint. Fadeaway jumper off the back of the rim. No good. And that'll be Fairfield ball. Max Allen contested the rebound. It was off him last.
Phenomenal job there by Leach there, holding his own against the bigger Allen, getting Fairfield the possession here. Now it's one possession at a time, Ryan.
Fairfield has a chance to take a lead for the first time, for not the first time in the second half, but for the first time in a long time. Goodine, he finds Leach with a backdoor cutter, and Leach gets the layup. Fairfield has the lead, 59-57, 4.5 minutes left.
You mentioned Jalen Leach needs to get it going. He has done just that, 6 points in the second half here.
Collins now, over to Daughtry. Allen, top of the key, guarded by Yetna. Dribbles, hands off, Collins. He switches over to Yetna. Collins trying to shake and bake, inside to Allen. Allen spinning when he's fouled. Louis Bleachmore commits the foul. Max Allen, as you mentioned, second team All-MAC. He's the key to the Red Fox operation offensively. He spent time on the bench getting his ankle looked at. He's been in foul trouble this entire tournament. He's a 65.6% free throw shooter.
Marist on the game, a perfect 8 of 8 from the line. These two free throws, forever, the most important so far.
Allen makes the first. Checking back into the game with four fouls is Jasper Floyd. Taking a seat is Louis Bleachmore.
And so, Casey absolutely needs him on the court right now, the defensive prowess that he is.
It's a major risk, especially because a lot of his game is steals, and reach and fouls are a part of that. So Allen looking to go 2 for 2 and tie this game up at 59. He does. This game is tied. 4 minutes, 8 seconds left. Floyd will get the ball and take it up the court. Passes the Fields. Fields across midcourt. Hands it back to Floyd. Floyd to Goodine. Goodine dribbling across the top of the key. Now to Fields. Fields dribbling inside is going to take it back out. Leach now. Leach, crossover, move into the paint. The layup with the right hand is good.
He will not be denied, Ryan. Jalen Leach, getting managed in own hands, getting it done, taking back the lead for the Stags.
Jalen Leach now, pretty move. He's coming awake here in the second half. 61-59 lead. Just over 3.5 minutes left. Max Allen now picks up his dribble, looking for someone, anyone. He's going to get it over to Javon Cooley in the corner, who gives it back to Allen. Allen driving to eight, spinning. He falls down. He grabs a loose ball, and it's going to fall out of bounds. But Yetna touches it. They're going to say it remains Marist review. This is going to be official timeout. I'm not sure if they're reviewing if it was off Yetna or not. It did not look like it was off Yetna. We're going to see if we get a replay on the scoreboard here. But we're in this official timeout. We're going to take a quick break. We'll update you what happens outside of the break. Stay right here. Fairfield 61, Marist 59, 3 minutes, 21 seconds left. We have a good one here in Atlantic City.
Is the world insane? If love and peace are so strong, why are the pieces of love that don't belong? Nations dropping bombs, chemical gases filling lungs of little ones with ongoing suffering. As the youth are young, so ask yourself, is the loving really gone? So I could ask myself, really what is going wrong in this world that we living in? People keep on giving in, making wrong decisions, only visions of them dividends. Not respecting each other, denying thy brother. A war's going on, but the reason's undercover. The truth is kept secret, it's swept under the rug. If you never know truth, then you never know love. What's the love, y'all? Come on.
I don't know.
But what's the truth, y'all? Come on.
I don't know.
But what's the love, y'all?
People killing, people dying, children hurting and crying. When you practice what you preach, would you turn the other cheek? Father, 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 help us. Send some guidance from above. These people got me questioning. Where is the love?
Where is the love? Where is the love?
Welcome back to Fairfield University Student Radio, 88.5 FM. I'm Ryan Canfield. He's Andrew Jameson. Logan Rundy doing a fantastic job on stats tonight. We have a great one here. Fairfield up 61-59. We're down by 9 points at one point in the second half. Caleb Fields has brought them back, and they've now taken a 2-point lead. 3 minutes, 21 seconds left. Both teams have committed 17 fouls. Both teams have two timeouts left. This will be Marist ball under the hoop.
And Marist has been in a drought as of late. No field goals in the last 7 minutes and 20 seconds. Fairfield is 3 of their last 3. Marist 0 of their last 5. Trying to go into this back-and-forth game, which it has been all game long.
There will be 6 seconds left on the shot clock. Jaden Collins, the inbounder. Allen, Daughtry, Pasquarelli, Cooley, the 5 on the floor for Marist. Collins, Pasquarelli, he finds him in the corner. Wide open, 3, off the back of the rim, no good. Goodine with the rebound.
Fairfield,
it's Fields, Floyd, Goodine, Yetna, and Leach, the 5 for Fairfield.
Fairfield's got to contest that, though. Pasquarelli is the last guy you want taking the 3.
Leach, he's got to give it to Fields. Fields now on the far wing. Dribbles back to the top of the key. Now back to the wing. Hands it off to Leach. Leach, the 3! It's blocked, and it's a foul! They're going to get Jaden Daughtry for hitting Leach on the arm on the way up. As I mentioned earlier, Leach leads the MAAC in free throw percentage. However, he's only 1 for 2 today at the line. He's going to have 3 massive free throws. And as Andrew mentioned before, Marist is perfect today. Fairfield is not. And when the games are this tight and the margin is so thin, the difference between winning playoff games and losing come down to the line. And Leach misses the first. 1 for 3, very uncharacteristic for him at the line tonight.
That's when he's going to want back, especially in this crucial of a moment.
Leach has picked up his play in the second half. He nails the 2nd of 3. It's now a 3-point lead, 62-59. Leach up to double digits on the night now, 10 points, and has been a force defensively. And Leach makes the 3rd. So Leach goes 2 of 3 in the line. Fairfield has a 63-59 lead. 2 minutes, 59 seconds left.
It is now a 2-possession game, Ryan. Pivotal free throws there by Leach.
Fairfield on a 15-2 run. Collins now. Pasquarelli on the wing. Pasquarelli on the baseline. He goes up for the layup. It's loose ball, and Jasper Floyd finds it.
Textbook defense there by Jalen Leach, keeping his hands up.
Slowing things down is Fairfield. Marist had a thrilling comeback against Niagara last night, and now Fairfield has one on them. Goodine now, and that's a loose ball. It's a loose ball again. Max Allen diving for it. Bodies on the floor everywhere, and Alexis Yenda's going to find it. 10 seconds left on the shot clock. Jasper Floyd across the court. Jalen Leach, 3! No good. What a wild sequence that was. Javon Cooley now. Marist down 4. Collins. Jaden Collins, just over 2 minutes left. Pasquarelli dribbles to the near wing. Max Allen top of the key, guarded by Bryson Goodine. Max Allen hands off to Cooley. Cooley the hot hand from 3. Rainbow pass into Allen. Allen looking to go up. It's rejected by Yetna. Jasper Floyd with the board. Stags are going to slow things down.
Phenomenal defense there by Yetna. Marist is 0 for their last 6 from the court.
And we're cleaning up the floor with a wet spot here. And Fairfield's going to take it back again. Jasper Floyd still with 4 personal fouls. Remember that. He is still on the floor. They brought him back in about 4 minutes left. He's played mistake-free basketball regarding fouls so far.
Now, Brian, it's a matter of quality over quantity here in these final possessions.
63-59, 1 minute 48 seconds left. The Fairfield men's team looking to join the Fairfield women's team in the championship game tomorrow night. Fields, worked over by Cam Ferris. Cam Ferris in the game for Pasquarelli. Fields taking his time dribbling right next to the logo. Fields is going to get a screen. Now over to Leach. Leach driving to the passes over. Jasper Floyd for 3 off the back of the rim, too strong. Almost stepping out of bounds, gathering the rebound is Jaden Daughtry, but does not. Cam Ferris now. Minute 15 and rolling left. Marist down 4. Both teams in the bonus. Max Allen now. Allen picks up his dribble. Hands it off to Cooley. Cooley back to Allen. Allen hands it off. Daughtry. Daughtry into the paint. His layup, a nice nifty move up and under to cut the lead to 2.
Tough finish by a tough player there in Daughtry.
59.8 seconds left. Fairfield 63. Marist 61. 2 timeouts left for each team. Do not go anywhere. This is an official's timeout. We'll be right back.
As I'm getting older, your people get colder. Most of us only care about money making. Selfishness got us following the wrong direction. Wrong information always shown by the media. Negative images is the main.
That was the quickest officials timeout we've had all night. So I want to take a moment to recap that wild sequence. So as Fairfield was doing passing plays in the offensive zone, the ball was booted not once, but twice, all the way back onto the Marist side of the court. And Max Allen dove, a bunch of two other Stags dove. The Stags ended up with it, got it to Alexis Yetna in half court, who found Jalen Leach open for the three on the wing where he missed it. That was just a wild sequence, bodies on the floor everywhere. So now, just so everyone knows, the possession arrow to the Stags. These always come up late in these moments. Inbounding the ball for the Stags will be Jalen Leach. It's Leach, Fields, Floyd, Yetna, and Goodine on the court for Fairfield. It'll be Daughtry, Ferris, Collins, Cooley, and Allen. Stags get the ball in. Under a minute to play, they have a two-point lead, each team with two timeouts. Fields now. Worked on by Ferris. He's dribbling on the MAAC championship logo, letting the clock wind. Just over 10 seconds on the shot clock. Fields drives, scoops up with the right-hand layup, no good. Rebound loose. Floyd corrals it, gets it back at the Leach, and Leach is going to sit on it.
Jasper Floyd has done that all season. None
just over 30
moment.
Seconds left. 12 on the shot clock. Fields has a chance to hit the dagger here. Fields dribbling on the logo. Step back, gives it to Yetna. Yetna has to throw up a three. The shot clock goes down. Chaotic, no good. His shot was bothered. Goodine caught it in midair and tried to put it in, but it didn't matter because the shot clock had expired. 15.7 seconds left. Fairfield has a two-point lead. Marist is going to get the ball. The previous play is under video review because they're trying to figure out if the shot clock should have been reset after Goodine grabbed the ball. We're going to see if they show a replay here on the big board. But regardless of what happens, we're not going anywhere during this break. This has been an unbelievable game, and this finish has lived up to everything the game has delivered so far. Fairfield, they hung around, and now they had a chance to go up two possessions with 20 seconds left and couldn't get the job done.
Yeah, no, that's one Leach is definitely going to want back. However, this is the type of game where you have to put that behind you and focus on the present. None of that matters as long as you get a W at the end of the day, Ryan.
Yeah, and Marist, like we said yes earlier in the broadcast, they had a thrilling comeback against Niagara just to be here tonight. And now they've had the role reversed on them where Fairfield has pulled off the comeback. So we've gotten a ruling. We've gotten a ruling from the officials. And we also have a couple substitutions.
I believe the clock will reset here to 17 and a half seconds. It will be Marist's ball on the other side.
Yes. So we have Allen, Cooley, Pascarelli, Collins, Ferris as the five for Marist. For Fairfield, they're running the same five they have been. Fields, Floyd, Leach, Yetna, and Goodine. 17 and a half seconds left. Marist has a chance to take the lead or just tie the game on this possession. Andrew, would you go for a two or a three here?
Marist, you have to play for the tie. That is a better shot at guaranteeing you more basketball, but given their hot three-point, I don't know, honestly.
Collins racing across half court. 12 seconds remain. Collins trying to go in on Fields, and he gets it popped out, but he regains. Bounce pass into Allen. They're blowing it down. It'll be a timeout. So the second that Collins regains possession, Coach Dunn took his final timeout. 7.7 seconds left. And folks, this is a nail biter here down at Jim Whelan Boardwalk Hall in Atlantic City.
We thought St. Peter's Quinnipiac was entertaining. This one has lived up to the hype and then some, Ryan.
So similar circumstances, it was 60-60 in that St. Peter's game against Quinnipiac. And with about 12 seconds left, the St. Peter's Peacocks advanced the ball past half court. They drew up a play. They had a layup. They missed, but they got a tip in as time expired to send them to the championship. Is Fairfield and Marist going to have that same kind of heroic ending that's going to send them into a game tomorrow night?
Let's hope for not the opposite of that, but in Fairfield's favor. However, if you're Fairfield right now, if I'm Coach Chris Casey, no threes whatsoever. Overtime is not the end of the world, although not ideal, but at least with no threes, you're guaranteeing more time and possession, more opportunity to win this game as opposed to being down.
The clock has been bumped up to 8.3 seconds. Now, Andrew, what are your thoughts on Fairfield fouling Marist and forcing them to take free throws and taking the three-point shot out of the equation?
I'm not going to take any chances fouling Marist because they have been perfect from the line. 10 of 10, and it hasn't been just one guy. All guys have made their free throws, so do not give Marist any chances from the foul line.
Marist only is 69% as a team coming into this, and we saw, Andrew, in the other game we watched, Manhattan, Shaquille Bender had a chance to tie it with three free throws late in a similar pressure pack situation.
Fairfield
and
does,
he missed them.
Fairfield does have two timeouts to get. That's going to be interesting to see. However, if I'm Coach Chris Casey, do not give Marist a chance. Legends are made in March, and they are capitalizing on their free throws right now.
Inbounding the ball will be Jaden Collins. And now Chris Casey's going to take a timeout. So Chris Casey waited to see what the formation was on the inbound play for Marist, and now he's taking his timeout. A little chess game going back and forth. Fairfield now has one timeout left. Andrew, this gives us more time to digest what then you can't lose. And
right.
You at least have overtime. Whereas if you don't foul and they get a three, your season could be over and you don't have a chance to touch the ball.
I understand
again.
Your philosophy there behind that. However, the refs are calling fouls in the slightest. We have seen some calls go 50-50 that more often than not resulted in a foul. I would not take any chance and play a more conservative game. However, it's up in the air as we are not on the court ourselves.
Yeah, I mean, if my two cents, make them make the free throws. And if they make them, so be it. And if you foul them right away, you're still going to have a chance to get the last shot. Whereas if you let them shoot a three, your season could be over before you get a chance to do so.
Fairfield does have one timeout remaining. That is important to note. Marist,
so
no timeouts.
It's Collins, Allen, Daughtry, Pascarelli, Cooley on the floor for Marist. 8.3 seconds left. Here we go. Collins the inbounder. He can't find anybody. Gets it inside. It's a loose ball. Allen finds it. That's a foul. That will be a foul. But it'll be on the floor. It doesn't matter because they're in the bonus anyway. So Max Allen, they're sick. Not a smooth inbounds play.
Not at all.
At all. Max Allen on the season, 65.6% free throw shooter. On the game today, he's 2 for 2.
Well, Ryan, your philosophy has come true. Allen with the two most important free throws of his life right here.
7 seconds. The clock went from 6.7 to 7 seconds. They added 0.3 seconds. The Fairfield faithful getting rowdy. Max Allen at the line. The first shot, it's a 1-1, is no good. Leach has the board. Jaden Leach scrambling. He's fouled with 4.8 seconds left. Max Allen did not make the first leg of a one. It's about Jaden Leach. He's been phenomenal at the free throw line all year. Yet tonight, only 3 of 5. But still, I don't think there's anyone Chris Casey would want at the line than Jaden Leach right now.
What do these types of experience favor? Experience, Ryan. Leach is as experienced as they come on this Fairfield roster, the senior out of New York.
5.1 seconds now. They added time back onto the clock. Substitutions have been made. Max Allen is checked out of the game for Marist. Jackson Price back in. Louis Bleachmore is going to come in the game for Alexis Yetna. Is Yetna not a strong free throw shooter? Leach. His first free throw is good. Fairfield holds a 64-61 lead.
Let's not get carried away here. Leach needs to seal this one to make it a two-possession game.
Can't talk about the importance of this next free throw. Leach, his second, is good. 65-61, Fairfield. Marist has no timeouts. They're down 4. Cooley, football pass. Price, turnaround 3. The bank is no good. The ball is loose. There's a whistle blown. The whistle blew, and the clock never started. You've got to be kidding me.
That's the last thing we need
and
here.
And you know what? Remember, we had the one referee get hurt earlier in the game. There's 4 referees. The one on the scores table left and is now on the floor. So they had to bring in someone else who is in charge of the clock in these situations.
It's that type of night here in Atlantic City, Ryan.
And wow. So they literally, Cooley, lefty, threw a pretty good ball. to Jackson Price, who was about 5 feet behind the three-point line, turned around, threw it up, missed. Fields would have had the rebound. The clock would have ticked off, and this game would have ended right here.
Coach Dunn was not pleased with that play call as Pierre Price chucked it from the logo. I know you're in desperation mode. However, Coach Dunn thinks that there could have been a better shot possibly.
So they're reviewing to see how much time should be on the clock. Fairfield up four. Fairfield does have one timeout left, which they could choose to take once they see the formation in which the Red Foxes are going to come out with. The five on the floor for the Stags appear to be Bleachmore, Goodine, Fields, and I can't see who's behind Leach. He's doing a great job screening.
It looks like
it'll
that's
be Jasper Floyd.
Floyd.
And the five for the Red Foxes, Collins, Pasquarelli, Daughtry, Price, and Cooley. What a game we've had tonight.
What an atmosphere.
Excellent two semifinal games we've had. Snafu. The Fairfield faithful celebrating and enjoying the music as if this game is already over.
Don't Stop Believing is a banger, Ryan.
Most certainly is. Chris Casey takes over just before the season starts after Jay Young fired about weeks before the season starts. Gets the interim tag removed at the beginning of this week after starting 0-6, has brought his team on the verge of making the MAAC tournament championship game.
There was
just an incredible job that Casey has done this season
and
to rally this team together and bring them to this point.
There's a reason interim was removed from his title. He has delivered and then some, starting 1-6 on the season, propelling this team to a potential final berth in the Metro Athletic Atlantic Conference. Couldn't ask more from Chris Casey.
Handed a really tough hand and has done the absolute best he can. So after all of that happens, they're leaving 2.1 seconds on the clock. It'll be Fairfield inbounding the ball. Leach the inbounder, Goodine, Floyd, Bleachmore, Fields on the court. All they need to do is get it in. Casey can take a timeout if he wants to. Leach. The inbounder. Holds. Timeout. So they're going to take a timeout. They're not going to take any chances. So that's their final timeout. 65-61 remains score. 2.1 seconds left.
In play. So interesting to see whether or not they'll do a long heave or a tip up in the air, or whether they're going to try to ice it with some more free throws. Marist, nonetheless, is going to be ball-hawking the Stags. We know that. That is a fact.
The entire Fairfield bench has gotten up the huddle around Chris Casey as he draws in this final inbound play. So after that 30-second timeout, the final one for both teams. Caleb Fields put the team on.